Mr. Jordan, and welcome back to another Scratch Card video, where today in this video we are doing developing theme park 3D. So there's been a long time since the last episode of developing theme park 3D, and a lot has changed. We have a pause screen, a resume button, an information button, and an exit button. So if we press our green flag, we do have a new intro. So this is our intro. Crazy intro that you get, and this magic carpet goes to the mouse pointer sometimes, and it normally does swell, but sometimes it doesn't swell and stuff, so you just have to wait for that to do. Then it goes like this, and the magic carpet goes around randomly. And then when you press info, you're led to this screen, and then you just press that to return. This button here, and it swells out. Let's do that again. Right, so it's here, and we press it, and it swells out. So that's good. So here we go, it's swirling out now. Okay, right, now start, and it mosaics away while it's loading. Now I've finished the arrows since the last episode, and I've got rid of the numbers. The arrows have an animation while it's loading, because normally it just goes all weird. Now let me show you the pause screen. So you press the pause up here. This comes up. You can press resume, which just resumes. You can press information, which just leads you to the information screen. And I am going to write some information on this screen. And then you can press exit, which leads you to the main menu when it does. Here we go. So it leads us to the main menu, and the background doesn't always come up. So that is what we're going to do quickly now. So if we just press the exit button, we will switch backdrop to backdrop one. Yeah, it should work, but for some reason it doesn't. It's because of all the graphic effects and stuff, but it will. I'll sort that by the next video. So by the next video, it will be sorted. But that's not what we are doing in today's video. We are going to be sorting out the management button, which will be at the top. And when you click it, a bit will slide down. And this piece will be like, it will have like the overview of the park, what rides you own and stuff. So yeah, when we get into the rides, then there'll be rides owning and stuff. So yes, so let's now take a look. Wait, no, not let's not take a look. I'm going to add the management button up now. So here it is. So it just hides when the green flag is clicked, and then it goes to its place when the backdrop switches to backdrop 2. So what we're going to make it do is we're going to make like a sprite, like appear and then slide down. So we'll do that now. Okay, right, I'll just add the sprite and then I'll code it with you. Okay, so here it is. It's covering the management button. So what we have to do is we have to put when green flag clicked, hide. Okay, and then we put the management button needs to broadcast something, so it will broadcast. So we need when this sprite clicked, broadcast management. That's spelt weird, but okay, management. So when that's clicked, it will broadcast management. So that means that on this sprite will be when I receive management, show. But it will show in a different way. It will go to where it is now. Go to glide 1 second to. So it will glide 1 second to this position here, which will change now. So it will glide 1 second to here. Maybe 2 seconds. So we'll give it 2 seconds to glide. so that means it has 2 seconds to glide when it receives management. So we'll go now, we'll just run the code a bit, exit to the exit screen, press on here. For these, I've just realised we need to put when backdrop switches to backdrop one, hide. And we can just copy that onto here. So that's when backdrop switches to backdrop one, hide. So they both hide when it switches to backdrop one. But that's not what we want. What we want it to do now is we want when the black sprite is clicked. So when this sprite clicked, we just want it to glide 2 seconds. To minus 95, 108. So when that glides to minus 95, 108, it will then hide again like that. And that will be the management button. So let's go now. So here we go, it's gliding, click it. Glides back up, disappears. So here it comes again. Good, and then click it now, and it will go back up. There, so that's what we want it to do. But there is another thing that we now want it to do. So when it's on this, we want the management to show like the money. So it will be, so the money will be shown here, so we'll make a variable, and this variable will be money. So money, we type in money. So this is for all sprites, so we have money. Now money will always be here, but what we want it to do is when this sprite clicked, show variable money. When the green flag clicked, hide variable money. Oh wait, when this sprite clicked, hide variable money. So show variable money needs to be here. So that's hide variable money. Okay. Right, let's try this now then. So if we press, yeah. And we press this. Oh. When this sprite clicked, that's meant to be a hide variable money. So we'll change that for hide variable money. And then we press this. Management slides down, money's there. We press this, money goes away. We press management, money comes, press it goes back up. But I want money to come when it's there. So basically, like, does it come up? It comes up like a bit before sometimes. So management, and then like comes up before, doesn't it? I don't know, but anyway, now what we're going to do is we are going to edit this so that it has rides written. So we are going to add like a button that says rides on it. So when I've added the button that says rides on it, I'll be back. Okay, so we have our two buttons. So we have games and food and the rides. So this will like lead to a page. So like when you buy a ride, other stuff will show up. So it will be all be automatic. And in the next video, we will be adding a food place. So that it will like show what you own and then what you can get. What you can get will be like a different, like lower color. But we are going to quickly do edit these so that when it's the right time, then they appear there. So we want when green flag clicked, go to the place where it is now, hide, and we'll do the same for this one. So we just copy that over here, go on motion, go to there, get rid of. So that is that so far, and then we want, what's this do? Does it broadcast? Yeah, when I receive management, so when I receive management, wait 2 seconds, because 2 seconds is when, like, how long it takes for the thing to slide down, so they'll only appear after 2 seconds. Wait 2 seconds, shut, and then that's that for now. So if we copy that onto here, and then we have to make it, when this sprite clicked, it will broadcast something. So when it's clicked, it will broadcast management off, okay? So broadcast management off, management off, and then when I receive management off, when I receive management off, hide, looks hide. Here we go. So this will now work. Well, it should anyway. So we'll just quickly save it and press management. Oh no, we'll press up first. So then hide, there we go. And now we press management. So here it comes, and then it's there. And then we press management again. To make it a bit more obvious, what I'm going to do for this is, like, I'm not going to make another sprite, but in the costume, I'm going to sort of, like, add a return button. Okay, so I'll add a return button, then I'll be back. Okay, so I've done that now. So people will, like, mistake it for an actual return button, but instead of it being a return button, it's just a sprite. So it's, like, when you click the sprite. I don't know why it's up there, but it shouldn't be. I'm just going to go off of this so that it loads properly. Oh, here we go, it's loading. We want all of this to come in front of it. So, like, to get stuff in front on Scratch, you can put loads in front, or you can just drag it in front and it remembers that. So, yeah. So, it is pretty good. So... yeah, this is about the end of this video here. I would like to thank you very much for watching. Everything will be sorted by the next video, and I will see you all later. Goodbye!